We've travelled down to Guildford today. We're at Signify and it's an absolutely glorious day. So don't feel sorry for us, but what are we down here for?
Well, we're here to follow up on a product we've seen on the channel before, Gary. We've previously reviewed the Philips lighting solutions for upper air and surface disinfection. And as we all know, we've been living through challenging times, but now we're thinking about returning to work and employers want to make their spaces as safe as possible for their employees. So we're going to see how Powercor have installed those products within the Signify offices and how they enable the solutions, Gary. So we're going to start this UVC journey by looking at surface disinfection, and the most common application area for that is the toilet. Now, we're looking for Kyle from Powercor, and rumour has it he's loitering in this toilet. Kyle, are you in here?
Yes.
Ah, there he is. Well, filming locations don't get more glamorous than this, and he's the person responsible for this installation. It's Kyle from Powercor. So Kyle, what have you installed in this rather glamorous toilet?
So we have installed some UVC batten fittings above the sink areas over here, as well as smaller batten fittings in each cubicle. In addition to that, we've got the sensors that get triggered in each cubicle and the main toilet and the front door. We've got door contacts on each door before entering. And additionally, we've got the emergency stops in case of an emergency and somebody's locked in the bathroom.
Okay, so obviously a lot of that's because exposed UVC light doesn't mix well with people. So it's a lot about the safety of the users.
Correct.
And you've wired that back to a control system.
We have, yes, which okay. is just outside.
Well, let's go and have a look at that and see how it all works together. So Kyle, you've brought me here to the control system you've installed. Just briefly talk through how the system works.
Right, first and foremost, we need to make sure that the area is clear of any people.
Okay, so that's, yeah. And how do you do that though? You've put sensors in there?
We have indeed. There's a sensor in each area as well as each cubicle.
Okay, because the PIR sensors as well, aren't they?
Yes.
Yeah, and obviously we've all seen the CAD operator in the office who doesn't move enough and the light switches off above his head. There is a risk that somebody in there could, yeah, possibly be asleep, and it would be possible to activate the system. So that's why that human check's there.
Is there, correct.
Okay, so you've cleared the area. What happens then?
Once the area is clear, we'll come out to arm the system. When that happens, it'll check to make sure that every area is clear before we set it. There's then a countdown timer before the system is engaged. And if everything's clear, the system will engage.
Okay, and how long does that run for?
That can run from 15 minutes up to an hour.
So the system's now running for 15 minutes, but what happens, you know, you've armed the system, then walked off, and are trying to walk in there to obviously use the toilet.
So another safety procedure we have in place is door contacts on every door. So as soon as that door contact is broken, the system disengages.
Okay, and you've also added a further, I guess, if all these safety measures didn't perform, there is still an emergency stop button in there as well.
There is, there's one in each bathroom, and if somebody did get caught in there, they can hit that emergency stop.
Okay, so I mean, this, you said it is a pre-built control system?
It is, it comes all ready to go, okay, well, sort of out of the box.
Well, let's have a little look in the box just to see how easy that was to wire. Keep the eFIXX viewers happy. If we don't see some wiring for a while, I get a little bit nervous. Right. So this is built around a standard Dynalite control system?
It is.
What's going on in the panel here?
So we have power coming in, and then that gets routed through a contactor, which brings the lights on the bathrooms. We have the emergency stops coming back, which are wired in, the door contact, and all the sensors.
That's a pretty neat panel, I say. It's all configured. Now, we know one of the issues with UV is obviously over time the lamps degrade. How do you know at what point you need to possibly look at replacing the lamps?
So built into the system, we have a screen which counts up every time they've been used, and that will indicate when we need to change the lamps. I can just demonstrate that.
Okay, so it's good. Yeah, it warns you that it's getting close to close replacement and then lamp replacement required. So all in all, this looks like a pretty good system that deals with the safety aspects of what could be a challenging system.
It does, yes.
Well, let's go and find Gary. I think he's with Matt somewhere looking at the upper air disinfection system that you've also installed in this office. Is this becoming a sort of a major business opportunity for Powercor?
It is, yes. We've seen a steady incline in the inquiries into UVC. We've already installed them in rugby clubs, schools, and some public transport offices.
So I've tracked Matt down and he's in the plant room. I've got one thing to address first, Matt.
Yep.
This is Kyle's high visibility jacket, and it looks absolutely immaculate. However, yours, Matthew, looks like it's been used by somebody doing work. What have you been up to on this project?
Okay, so we work nights just to ensure the safety of everyone, so there's no one in the building. There's a team of myself and two of my colleagues. We have followed a design whereby the upper air units are split into six zones, and we've wired it in FP200.
Right, and behind you've got the control panel. I can see all the lights are illuminated. Should we have a look in there?
Yeah, sure, let's have a look.
So the six zones are illuminated then, Matt, so I take it that the wall and ceiling mounted UVC lamps are currently on?
Yeah, correct.
So if I want to look in here, I've got to press the emergency stop, is that right?
Yeah.
I've already done it, so we're in trouble already. So open up our panel. Oh, this looks like it was purpose-built, unlike the one Gordon saw that was actually shipped in, is that correct?
Yeah, that's correct. So Powercor purpose-built this unit as opposed to the one outside the bathroom unit. And it houses all of the control systems. So you've got network power supply, the Dynalite relay control system, and then up top you have the essentially the outgoing circuits for all the different zones.
So this is the FP200s going out feeding the wall and ceiling mounted ones. We've also got the OPTEX red scan, which I think those lasers are wall mounted. And is it when one of those is broke that actually knocks off the system?
Yeah, correct. Actually, just above, we've got the OPTEX red scan PoE switches.
So power over Ethernet, that sounds rather technical. Shall we pass that one back over to the old clean coats?
Yeah, probably best to.
So Carl, we're out here in the main office area. So what we've actually installed on the UVC side out here?
So we've got some upper air wall mounted UVC units. And we have also got the OPTEX red scan sensors.
Okay, so we learned in our last video that we made about these products, there's a lower risk when it comes to these upper air disinfection unit. The main risk is if someone was to, say, climb on a desk, hanging some Christmas decorations up or something like that, and they're staring into the unit. So how does the red scan device help with that safety precaution?
So yes, you're correct. There's always an opportunity where somebody could stand on a desk or a contractor could come in, climb up some steps and be exposed to the UV light. We've installed some OPTEX red scan sensors, which basically cast a beam across just below the fittings. As soon as that beam is broken, it'll turn the units off in the zone.
Okay, so if I was to jump from here into the path of the UV light, it should cut off?
Correct.
Oh, well, that's a pretty sensitive device. So is that a laser beam sort of that does that?
It is, yes. So it casts a beam 20 square meters, which we've cropped to fit the installation of this building. And when you break that beam, anything greater than 10 millimeters, it'll cut the power off to the units via our control panel.
Wow, that's a great solution. So you developed that just obviously for this first install.
Yes.
Yeah. In terms of placement of the UV units, how's that decided how many you need and how far apart they should be?
So an initial survey was undertaken by Signify. They will determine the space and the requirements for what volume needs to be sanitized by the UVC units. And it all comes into heights of ceilings, space, obstacles. They'll calculate that and they'll give us a plan.
Okay, and then it was, yeah, we've seen that Kyle did all the work installing it. And yeah, we come along for the bit to celebrate the results as people come back to work. What a great environment we've got here to come back to work. What have we got installed here in this breakout zone?
So we've got the upper air disinfectant UVC lights.
Okay, and they give a 360 degree output against the ceiling?
Correct, yes.
Yeah, and you've installed these in here and also in the cafeteria area as well. But I notice there's also a lot of things hanging from the ceiling. We've got some pendants and yeah, Philips are always changing the range. Did you have to make a count of those when you start looking at those sensors?
We do. So within that laser range, we've got to account for anything that's hanging in the area, make sure that we've got the whole area covered, and we may need to mask out a few areas. Additionally, if anything does change in that space, we need to be able to come back and recommission those lights to make sure that they are in the right location.
eFIXX viewers know I'm big on my training and my CPDs. We're all qualified electricians. Was there any additional courses, Carl, that we had to take in order to install this?
Yes, there was. We needed to undertake the Signify training course for UVC, which included understanding the product, installation, and commissioning.
Apart from that, the electrical system is identical to any other we would be fitting, is that right?
Yes, it is.
So with that in mind, we'd like to thank Powercor for showing us around today, and I'm going to grab Gordon and see what he's up to. So what do you think you've learned from my trip down here to Signify?
Well, it's been fantastic to see those products were featured on the channel a few months ago put into practice. And what people mustn't forget is that UVC is not a new technology for disinfection. You know, you could put it in the air conditioning system, and a lot of people are starting to talk about that now. But what we believe is the air conditioning system has to work incredibly hard for that to be effective. There may be some regulation changes coming up that means you have to have more air changes in an environment, in a space, and UVC can help you get around that. But remember, also getting to those surfaces we saw in the toilet, you can't do that from the air conditioning.
No, and I think Powercor demonstrated there clearly this is an opportunity to electrical contracts, and they've done a fantastic job here, haven't they?
They have. Understood the requirements of the client and then gone off and searched out the best solution for the safety requirements of the system, and a cracking install that hasn't disrupted the work here. So I bet people are really looking forward to getting back in and driving it forward.
As always, we're interested in your comments and your feedback. Please leave those all below and we'll try and get back to as many as we can.